This is Sway.
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 In the morning.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Don't shake your body.
Wake your fuck ass up.
That crust out y'all.
It's been a great morning, man.
Hell yeah.
It's been a great morning. Fresh off the plane, watched my daughter graduate from high school. Kiyomi, proud of you. Daddy's proud. Came from the plane, came to work. My team was holding it down. Team, I'm proud of you. You know.
Hey.
Vic Minster stopped by, had a great conversation with Vic. Mm-hmm. Shay Mitchell from Pretty Little Liars came by, beautiful young lady. Last season of Pretty Little Liars, we're sad, but we're happy to see what's next. The beautiful, gorgeous Nia Long, who I promise you, the way she looked at me was as if she wasn't engaged, something could have happened.
Something.
And now, man, I'm really excited about this artist that is here today, but I'm excited for a number of reasons. I've known of him for quite some time. We have mutual friends. We've hung out together. We broke bread together. We smile. We laugh. And I've been hip to his movement for a long time and always knew that at some point, your shit gonna pop. You know, and it's starting to pop now. He's been going on tour with Maxwell.
Well, I'm going on tour with Maxwell.
Going
Friday.
On tour with Mark Maxwell this Friday.
Woo. Congratulations. Yeah.
Who gets Thank to you. Go on tour with Maxwell?
For real, that's the question.
DB and I were talking about this series, this EP series.
I know this dude,
yeah,
man.
I've known him for the longest, man.
How you know DB?
Through Sarah.
Sarah and Damon. Yeah.
Who
those people?
Sarah shot the album
cover,
right?
Hold up. You guys are doing this all wrong. First of all, welcome to the show, future Grammy Award winning Roll James, ladies and gentlemen.
Yay!
Bystorm artist.
I'll take
what
that.
Up, bro?
What's up?
Heather, you know who Bystorm is?
Sam just broke it all down to me really, really nice. But let it. I know.
Yeah.
Legendary.
Yes.
Music executive and mogul.
Yeah.
Mark used to bring Biggie, Notorious B.I.G. to the West Coast to come see us on the Wake Up Show.
Yep.
Now, who's Sarah? Well, it's Sarah.
So Sarah's a photographer, and we've been all friends with her, and she shot my first video. And her first video she shot was my first video. Yeah, so she's branched off and done her thing too. And now I just brought her back for the album and for the cover. So we just know her mutually. She's amazing, man.
Which video was that?
Pledge Allegiance.
Pledge Allegiance. How long ago was that?
3 years, almost four.
Damn, okay.
Yeah,
so
it's crazy, right?
When did we first meet? Do you remember?
About four years ago. Right when I was about to put it out.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. And shout out to John Gray.
John Gray.
Ghetto Gastro.
Word.
Which is interesting because, I hanging out with John Gray is like my little brother.
Yeah.
So, you know, we known each other for years. And you guys have it's a different kind of movement.
Yeah.
You know, there ain't no name for y'all collective. But Ghetto Gastro, they curate events. Mm-hmm. Using food as a premise, but bringing culture and nuances to corporations as well as just everyday average people.
Mm-hmm.
What was that like for all you guys at that time coming together as a collective and just feeding off of each other's energy?
I think it was very necessary. I think we all had these ideas of what we wanted to do, and we individually had something to contribute to the group of how we can expand it and come together and make it grow, you know. Uh-huh. So John was culinary.
Uh-huh.
I have friends over there that are in fashion, you know. Uh-huh. Jasmine, she's into the logistics and the, you know, metrics of all of this. Uh-huh. And then I was music, you know, and then like you yourself was there. So it was just a creative group of people who knew that we were good people and found each other and wanted to do something great together. So we just encouraged each other.
Which is beautiful because, you know, these are not mainstream people or names, but it was almost necessary to feed off of each other for each person platform to grow. Where early in the day, everybody had they move like silos, everybody moving in their own direction, right? And so each one bring one, so to speak, right?
Yeah.
What you were doing musically at that time, I wasn't hearing what you were doing musically at that time.
Right.
You know, now you're starting to hear a lot more folks experiment with the kind of soul that you were experimenting with back then. Is that a hindrance for you, or you think that's a open door for you?
I think it's an open door. I think that what it does is allow it opens people's ears and their perception and their, you know, their horizons for music. Like it allows them to be more open to a fresh approach of R&B, because all of this is basically a fusion of rock, R&B, country, hip hop, gospel, you know.
Yeah.
And it's the soul, and it's just, it's different. You know, when you listen to the radio, you hear it's a different.
That was so accurate. Yeah,
right. I mean, it's just different. I'm actually singing, you know, so I think what it does when you have a whole group of people do it, it brings a new sound. That's what brings the sound, is you hear all these people doing it. I mean, as far as for myself,
yeah,
I don't feel like anything that anybody else is doing compares to what I'm doing or where I even see myself in the next 5-10 years, you know, as I continually to evolve and grow and to roll this out. I don't see anybody who's in my lane.
Nobody compete with you.
Nah, man.
Roll James, ladies and gentlemen.
That's I love tunnel vision, man.
Yeah.
So earlier, Vic Mensa was here, Sway mentioned, and something that Sway said, how he really likes to see the entire process from an artist going from a seed and then blossoming. Yeah. Like, what's the middle part? And so sometimes I'm curious about the business aspect, because you still got to make money. You're a human being. Yeah. There's rent. There's food that needs to be eaten. So how do you make money before you get an album deal, before a major tour comes around like Maxwell as an artist?
Wow. To be honest with you, I haven't worked a job in like 10 years, right?
What's the secret?
It's kind of crazy, because I really dedicated myself to this. And I know that it's very hard, because a lot of people have to work to maintain their lives. My grandmother lives here, so she has a house in Queens that nobody lives in. Nice. And so I had the opportunity to stay there, stack my money, to travel and figure out what I wanted to do, figure out my sound, go and spend hours in the studio and not really have to worry about rent, because my family was supporting, you know. And as far as money, before I quit my job, I saved up a lot of money. So, and then, you know, just like family support.
Yeah.
But that's what it was, really.
Make like, use of your resources.
Yeah, make use of your resources and just have family supporting the vision, because it's not easy.
I get it.
You know?
Roll James is here. What's your social media? Because I want our citizenship. Look, to everybody tuned in, you know how we do. We like to bring artists that we think you should know. In case a lot of folks know your name, though. Your brand has been growing.
Yeah.
I guess that's Mark, Wayne, and Eddie. You know, you got a great team with you. But what's your social media?
Everything is Ro James XIX. ROJAMESXIX.
What does that mean?
XIX was I was born November 19th. I'm a Scorpio.
Oh,
hey, damn, I'm the
17th. Hey, see what's up?
Okay, now this song I'm gonna play next is, you know everybody got their baby making song. You know, okay, mine used to be "Do Me" by Prince. "Do Me, Baby." From way back in the day, classic. Nobody's familiar. I know Ro knows.
I know Ro knows. What you want us to say?
Now it's going to be this one. It's called "Burn Slow."
Yeah.
Roll James. 888-742-3345. You want to talk to him? Give him a call, citizens. Yeah. Waking up next to you in the morning. It's better than sunshine.
Oh. Look what you did to him, Ro.
Produce this, man.
The interns.
Interns
and Ryan Toby, man.
The whole album or just this song?
Just this song. We did interns got two on there.
Two on this?
Uh-huh.
Okay, and then who else you work with?
DJ Camper, Sounds. I did Happy Perez, D Mile. Like, you know, I kept it.
Yo,
fresh.
Yeah, man. This is it. This that shit.
Yeah, sounds so good.
Thank you.
Get up on this one. Don't be late to the party. Roll James.
Late.
Don't be late. But hey, better late than never.
That's true.
888-742-3345. Candy's on the line. Candy, good morning. How are you?
Hey, Candy.
Candy.
What's up, Candy?
I'm sorry to call back, but it's love.
I was wondering if it was her.
Roll James. I'm going to say to the listener, I love you, Ro. Like, I blogged about you, like, months ago around my mom's birthday in March. Like, for Misha, when I heard it, I was like, yo, like, this guy, he's got something, that production, his sound. I was listening. I'm like, yo, he's probably the closest thing to Prince I've got now. And then Prince died.
Man.
So, like, and I'm listening to you speak about your tunnel vision. So, like, as a blogger, because I blog about you, I really, really want to know, like, since you have this tunnel vision, like, do you see yourself as like, a great, upcoming great, like a Prince or a Michael? Because they also had tunnel vision. They were like, let's do, this is my goal, this is where I'm going, and I'm going to do that. Like, do you see that upcoming for you?
Absolutely. I mean, I had to decide that that's what I wanted to do. I think icon is the term. Mm-hmm. And I grew up listening to, like, Stevie and Marvin Gaye, Otis Redding, James Brown, Prince, Donny Hathaway, D'Angelo, you know. And Michael Jackson and Prince, I mean, to us is
that's
the biggest, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And they're not here. And for our generation, not to diss anybody, I just don't see anything like that. And so for myself, as far as my journey, what I want to do is just that. I want to start to make sure that I take the steps to icon. Yeah. You know what I mean? And that requires a lot of sacrifice. It means losing a lot of friends, losing girlfriends, because they don't understand that time is a premium, and the time that you give in a relationship is also time for the hustle, you know? So it's about finding balance. But at the same time, the sacrifice is worth it, because that's what I want.
You single now?
Yeah.
Good for you, man. You could you could go out there and bang, bang, bang with no pressure.
That's recent, though. But that's recent because, you know, like you said, the hustle. Yeah.
How long were you in your last relationship?
To be honest, the last relationship was a year. But before that, I had known her for a long time. So
how'd y'all break up? What'd you say?
It was kind of a mutual situation because she didn't understand the fact of, she didn't get the, I've known her for 10 years.
Yeah.
So in 10 years, people change and evolve and they grow and you figure out what you want to do with yourself. And sometimes you grow apart. If your vision doesn't align with mine, then we're going to grow apart. If you have your own plan, you're talking about you want to have a baby right now and get married. That's not a part of my year plan. And so
that's real.
And you know, and my year plan is to hustle and to get the icon. And if you can't align that and you realize that a child is, that's selfish to bring a baby into the world and you're not going to be there. You know, so, I mean, just those little things, just like we had to agree that it was bad timing.
It was bad timing.
That's honest. You know, a lot of times they'll say, depending on who you date, can help you go to icon status too. Would you date an artist?
If she ain't crazy.
I guess if she ain't crazy. That's no then.
That's a no.
Shush. Beyonce ain't giving Jay-Z too much drama.
Did you see Lemonade?
You don't know that. You don't know that.
That was opposite.
Did a whole album about. No, I'm
you
joking.
Know that. You don't know
that. That's true. We don't know what goes that's on behind true. Closed doors. We got. But she's worth the problem, so you gotta check the balances. If it is problems, she's definitely worth it. Chanel is in Chicago. What up, Chanel?
Hey,
say hello to Ro James.
What's up, Ro James?
What's up, Chanel?
Up, what's up, Tracy G?
Hey, Bo.
I just want to say I didn't know about Ro James, but this burns slow. Like, I just went and downloaded it on Tidal. Like, I'm fucking with it. It's
get
real
that.
Decent.
I like that. Thank you.
You know what?
You're very welcome.
Get the whole album.
Yeah. I'm definitely going to download the whole album. Definitely.
Check
I'm
that
just
out.
I'm so excited I got through. I was trying to get through with Heather to say, yeah, Rob, I'll be fucking
I love you, Chanel. Thank you, sis.
Yeah, the album is called ELDORADO. Go ahead and get that, Chanel. Okay?
ELDORADO. I will definitely trust me.
Matter of fact, trust me on this one, citizens. Buy this album, ELDORADO. If you don't like it, okay, if you listen to the whole album and you decide, you know, as a whole, I don't like this album, call us back. We'll send you something.
Mm-hmm. Bloop.
There it is. All right.
they're going to be calling. I hate it.
They're going to listen to it. And
they want
to
give.
What I like about what you guys are doing, because I notice a lot of R&B is doing what I don't like about rap. It's a lot of repetitiveness.
Yeah,
the approach to song structure and songwriting is, you know, when I hear Drake go, I don't want to hear nobody else, or I don't want to hear everybody else
do it. Yeah.
Do it. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah. And I don't hear you sounding or doing things that other guys are doing. Are you conscious of that, or are you just doing you?
Absolutely, I'm doing me. Mm-hmm. But I'm also conscious of it. Like, see, you have to be separate, but you have to be in the world at the same time.
Exactly.
So I listened to it, and I just, I'm like, that's not where I'm at. I appreciate that, and I appreciate such and such for what they're bringing, this person. As far as me, when I bring my music, I want people to be able to identify what it is and the separation of it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Whether it may be the lyrics, the melodies, my tone, the places I can go with my voice, you know. So, yeah, I try to separate myself, definitely.
You like that, HB. It's a lot of range in your voice, man. And it's interesting that Candy, I think, brought up Prince. And I know you're a Prince fan.
Yeah.
Spike Lee and I hosted a Prince party 2 weeks ago.
I heard about that.
Yeah, man, it was crazy.
I wish I was there, man.
Yeah, and the day he passed, we were in front of his house celebrating. Mm. And Prince wrote the kind of songs that made you want to sing along, man.
Mm-hmm.
I just thought maybe since we got you here, man, maybe we could get you to sing along.
Ooh.
Come on, bro.
Look what they did to the boy.
You know what I mean, Ro James? I mean,
all right.
You the homie, man. I mean, do you know the lyrics?
I know.
You got the range? You got the range? I mean, I might sing along with you.
All right, come on, let's do it. Let's do it.
I never meant to cause you any trouble.
I'll take the next one.
Okay. Hey, here we go.
All right, ready?
I never meant to cause you any pain.
You go ahead and take it from here, okay?
To see you laughing, yeah. Only want to see you laughing in the purple rain. Oh, love, see purple rain, yeah, purple rain.
Stop. I got caught up, man. I never had a man sing to me like that, man. I was like, this my homie, man. Let's stop the music.
You're so
crazy. I felt the spark.
Calloway, what you talk about? What Ro doing to you?
With the don't the don.
Shit, you got some soulful. You got an instrument over there or something soulful?
We
got to put you to work.
He about to put me to work, huh?
Is Tito's vodka your favorite?
Right, I was thinking that
too. You know what? No, Jack Daniels is, which is probably
Coke, cool. and Cadillacs.
That Honey Jack is banging too.
It is. With some lemonade or some apple juice.
With some iced tea.
Never had that.
With the iced tea, homemade iced tea.
Lush Talk with Heather B.
Hey, the happy hour.
Well, you got the Coke, Jack, and Cadillacs.
Cadillacs, yeah.
And
yeah.
So
yeah. Coke was my first girl.
Okay.
She was addicting. Coke is kind of bad for you. Coke shape.
Jack was
myself, smooth, but what comes with a punch.
Okay, and Cadillacs?
And Cadillac represented my journey. Cadillac was my first car, so.
Yeah. Cadillac, what year was it?
A 93 ElDorado.
Damn. Man, you had an engine problem, gas guzzler.
Yeah.
No. My first one was a 92. I have a 93 now. And
okay.
It's the same problems with the engine.
Yeah.
Is this engine, the car on the cover?
No, that's a 72. But it's the ElDorado, too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I want to hear something else. Okay, man.
Well, what you trying to hear,
bro? I just want to hear you maybe sing something you already have.
Or
you could, you know, vamp a little bit. If
okay.
You, okay, over this beat. The reason why I'm doing this because it's going to be so hard to get Eddie and Wayne and these guys to bring you back up here in the future. So I'm getting it now, okay?
Maybe one day when I grow up, when I'm done hustling, I buy my mama a house. Said the hustle never ends. Said it's always said I'm just beginning. Said I wanna buy my daughter all the things that she wants. Someday when I grow up, said I hope that she. Said I hope that she.
That's that boy, Ro James, ladies and gentlemen. That's that boy, Ro James, man. Nah, you got to come back, man.
He got me freestyling.
Yeah,
out here.
Man. I'm milking you.
I like him.
It's my homie. I take full advantage of my friends when they come up here. Congratulations,
thank
man.
You,
ElDorado is a great project. We're going to end today. I wanted to play that Holy Water joint.
Yeah,
that'll be the last song we play today.
Yeah.
But Permission is the one that's been really getting you a lot of burn.
Yeah.
It's gotten you a lot of recognition, so congratulations with
that.
So, tour Friday with Maxwell?
Friday on with Maxwell. Woo! I just got off with Erykah Badu, man.
Yeah.
That was great, too.
Congratulations, so, yeah. Man. That's dope.
Did she cook for you?
She didn't cook for me.
Okay.
I wish she did.
Yeah.
Sheesh. But I heard that she got the sauce, so you got to be careful with Erykah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's a whole different
she
kind
got
of sauce.
Sauce.
You're having more babies than you thought you wouldn't. Did y'all interact? Did she give you game?
Yeah.
What kind of
we
game?
We talked. I mean, she's so chill, man.
Yeah.
I got to sit in with something that she does, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
She like does this meet and greet with her fans, and she lets them ask her questions. She's sitting on the table with her feet out, just like real casual and chill. And I appreciated that.
Yeah.
And even just to watch her perform, it taught me so much.
Yeah.
Just to watch how to interact with her audience and
uh-huh.
the soul and the just her originality. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, man. Definitely.
That's you, man. Roll
All
James,
day.
Man.
Yeah.
Roll James.
Yeah,
X.
Man. XIX.
XIX.
Yep.
XIX. Roll James. ELDORADO, man. Citizen, trust me, buy the album. Hit me tomorrow.
Yeah.
And tell me what you think.
Let me know.
Okay. We want to thank our other guests, Vic Mensa, for coming by.
Shay Mitchell.
For coming by. Nia Long. And tomorrow's show, John. Oh, where's that? Okay. We got, I just got it. Ed O'Neill is coming by tomorrow. Wow. Damn. John Bellion is coming by tomorrow as well. And we're going to do our Rise and Shine segment. Tracy, how can they reach you?
Yo, Twitter. Find me on Instagram at it's Tracy G. ITSTRACYG. You can also visit my site, shesbeautyandthebeast.com.
Heather B.
At the happy hour, WHB on Instagram and Twitter.
Roll James, thanks for coming by. I'm at Real Sway on Twitter and Instagram. Hey, my Snapchat is popping again.
Yeah.
Follow me, Sway Calloway.
Same for Facebook, right?
Facebook, same thing, Sway Calloway. And once we get that millionth follower on Sway's Universe, I'm going to fly you and a guest to town. You can hang out in New York for one day. I'll give you some food money. You come by the show, and whoever's on the show, you'll be able to meet them. And until next time, ladies and gentlemen, we have nothing. Left to say.
It's Sway in the Morning, only on Shea 45.